Let's do it. What's going on? It's Tone Loc Week. Let's get it. Dissect DJs about to break it down.
You just say it's Tone Loc Week?
Tone Loc Week.
Nah, we're not doing that.
What's your problem with Tone Loc, man?
I love
You've
Tone Loc.
Always had this.
No, don't label me a Tone Loc hitter. I give Tone Loc a day. We can give it Tone Loc day. But I don't really believe his catalog is big enough to give him a whole week in this day and age. I don't know. I'm down with the Tone Loc day. Yeah, let's do it. Let's wild thing.
I just don't understand, dude, how you can hate. Tone Loc has all the jams, dude. He has all the jams. Like, he represents
early 90s. Name three.
Okay, we got Wild Thing.
Yeah.
Funky Cold Medina.
Of course.
And, what's that? He was in Ace Ventura, wasn't he? He was like.
Oh, yeah. He's dope in Ace Ventura. I don't think we could dissect a scene from him doing Ace Ventura.
What else? Was he in something?
Blank Check. Let's go. He was dope in Ice Ventura, but he was my ace in Blank Check. That's where he really won me.
Was he in Blank Check?
Oh, yeah. Funny story about Blank Check. When I first saw that as an 8-year-old, he had this dope.
Was he in any other movies?
No, I think that's it.
Well, tell me about the story about Blank Check.
When I was an 8-year-old watching Blank Check, I thought he was the dude that I wanted to be. I thought his voice was awesome, and I was like, man, I want to like talk like that and be a badass. And I should have been relating to the 10-year-old little jerk-ass kid that made a bunch of money for some reason. No. I related myself to Tone Loc. I'm like, that's what I want to be when I grow up. I want to have this dope-ass voice. Got to be a badass. I'm down with Tone Loc. Don't label me a Tone Loc hater right now. I'm not going to have it. I'm just saying, I don't know if he gets a whole week. We've already given a couple of, you know, one-hit wonder-ishes
all right.
A whole
week. Since we were able to name off two quick ones, can we do like a double episode?
Yeah.
Can we knock out a double episode?
We do a double episode, y'all.
We never done it. Yeah, first time for everything. Tone Loc, you get the first double episode.
I feel like we have in some way at some time. But like, I'm not going to...
But full, this is full on dissecting double. Wild Thing and Funky Cold Medina.
Let's ride.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Working all week, 9 to 5 for my money. So on the weekend comes, I go get live with the honey. Rolling down the street, I saw this girl when she was pumping. I winked my eyes, got into the ride, went to a club, was jumping. Introduced myself as Loc, she said, you're a liar. I said, I got it going on, baby doll, and I'm on fire. Took her to the hotel, she said, you're the king. I said, be my queen, if you know what I mean, and let's do the wild thing. Wild.
Yo, Tone Loc, he works a job, 9 to 5, which, you know, he probably was, because rappers in the 90s didn't make much money.
A lot of people do.
And, and he goes out to get live with the honeys. He was rolling down the street somehow, saw a girl, and she was pumping. Now, I don't know if she was looking good, or she had one of those shoes we always talk about, the Reeboks, and she was randomly pumping her shoes up at that exact moment when he was driving
by. She was down on her knees, just, like, tying her laces up, and we're like, let me get some pumps real quick.
Yeah, and then all he had to do was wink his eye.
Out of the car?
That's all he did. He says, I winked my eye, she got into the ride, went to the club, was jumping. So he saw a girl pumping up her Reeboks, winked his eye. She said, didn't ask questions, didn't say a word to him, they didn't speak. She's got into the ride. And then went to the club, which was jumping.
Hey, Tone, I got some rough news for you. You're going to find this out later in the night, but you definitely just picked up a hooker.
There's no way
from your car, you just gave a girl a wink and she just jumped in your ride. Like, no, she's definitely going to expect a payout.
Yeah, I'm coming up with this pumping, like, her Reebok.
No, she was looking fly.
Yeah, she was looking fly as shit. She had heels.
She was probably, dressed in some scandalous attire. Yeah.
And then check this out. So he takes her to the club.
So Tone is riding with a hooker.
Okay.
Carry on.
Takes her to the club. It was jumping. Now, this is the point in time which when Toke decides to introduce himself. Now, he hasn't introduced himself yet. They got into the car, got to the club. It was jumping. Now it's time for him to introduce himself as Loc. She doesn't believe him. She's like, you're a liar. He says, I got it going on, baby girl, and I'm on fire. And then somehow, some way, quickly takes her to the hotel. She says, "You're the king. Be my queen, if you know what I mean."
And let's do the wild thing. Yeah,
this, again, checks out. This is all shit that a hooker would say.
He was, a hooker.
She's ready to get her payout on. She's like, all right, let's do this.
He hasn't said anything about paying for anything. So I'm not.
Well, this isn't when they drop the chip hook on you. I don't think. I don't know. It's coming quick, though. I guess.
All right. So we've discovered that Tone Loc, on his way after work, picks up a hooker, takes her to the club, introduces himself. She doesn't believe him.
Might not realize that it's a hooker, though.
Introduces himself. She doesn't believe him. Somehow, from that point, takes her home. She says he's the king, and now they're about to do the wild thing.
Wow. At the mall, looking for some gear to buy. I saw this girl, she gonna rock my world, and I had to adjust my fly. She looked at me and smiled and said, "You have plans for the night?" I said, "Hopefully, if things go well, I'll be with you tonight." So we journeyed to a house, one thing led to another. I get in the door, I go hit the floor, looked up, and it was a mother. I didn't know what to say. I was hanging by a string. She said, "Hey, you too. I was once like you, and I like to do the wild thing. Wild thing." She loved to do the wild thing.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Did you get all that, Castle?
Kind of. Is this all happening, like, the same day?
I don't know. I think this is the next day. It had to be the next day because he took the last girl home. She said, "Be my queen."
Yeah, but then he said something about I had to adjust my fly.
Okay,
when
so
he saw the next one.
Let's go into this story. He was shopping at the mall looking for some gear to buy. Okay.
Then I would say no, it's not the same day. Because he saw this girl. He's not gonna be shopping for gear after.
Yeah, that's a different day. It's definitely a different day. Yeah. He saw this girl, cool, rock my world. So the girl just took him by storm immediately off the jump. Again, possibly could be.
Definitely, actually. Wait, she just approached him and ran up on him?
No, no, he saw the girl and she rocked his world. Just by, like, looking at her,
way of saying she was pumping.
Yeah, she was pumping, which then again might lead to the fact that she might be a hooker again. Let's keep an eye on this two hours we're talking. And he had to adjust his fly at that point for some reason.
That shit happens sometimes. Yeah. You know? You ever had jeans where they just kind of fall down on your own? Yeah. I've gotten rid of jeans just for that reason alone. I'm like, this shit is making me look sloppy, man.
Those are the worst type of jeans. Yeah. But sometimes they lead to a conversation that's worth having. You know what I mean? Yeah. So
the homie Greg had a conversation opener with Chili from TLC from that exact thing one time. And she's zipped it up himself. I don't know. I'll ask him if he wants me to include that in here, but if he does.
What? Greg was with Chili for TLC?
She zipped up his platform. Wow. Yeah, I know, man. So sometimes I'm saying it could give you some inadvertent plus side.
Continuing on, she looked at me and smiled and said, "You got plans for the night?" I said, "Hopefully if things go well, I'll be with you tonight." So we journeyed to her house. One thing led to another. Okay, so the hooker thing is continuing to ride through the story that Tone Loc is very attracted to meeting. But then it could not be. They could just meet at the mall with a young lady that was just down immediately. But it's still an option. There's still an option of both happening.
He's like, "You want to shop for some DSWs real quick?"
And she's like, "Yep."
Let's hit up the sheet.
All right, let's forget the hooker aspect and just go for
I'm going to try to, but it kind of keeps punching him in the ear.
True, right? But let's act like he just met a girl. All
right.
Somehow he talked her into with his game of hopefully if things go well. I mean, you and I. One thing's led to another, okay? I keyed the door, cold hit the floor, looked up, and it was her mother.
Nice. Okay. So he looked at the
door, and then somehow he hit the floor because it was her mother standing there at the house that he just went to with the girl from the mall that he just randomly had enough game to pick her up.
They might keep you that from me sometimes, you know? They're not trying to tell you the whole home situation because they just want you there. Next thing you know, you're in the kitchen and, like, Pops walks in.
That would have changed this whole song immensely. But instead, he looked up and it was her mother. He didn't know what to say. He was hanging by a string. She said, "Hey, you two, I was once like you, and I like to do the wild thing." Did Mama just throw herself to try to be in a, like, menage a trois thing here? Or was she just trying to, like, let them know that I know what you're doing and get it? Because if it was the menage a trois thing, she's then trying to do a thing with her daughter as well, which makes this completely crazy and awkward story. But then again,
there are some scandalous mamas out there, man. You go to, like, Beverly Hills or something. Hollywood.
We're hating on Beverly Hills.
I'm not hating on them. I'm just saying. I don't know. Watch some of them Real Housewives shows. I mean, I haven't, but, like, I'm pretty sure you'll come across some of the moms that are like, if their daughter brought home something that they were like, that's a yummy piece of bite right there. What's your story? Y'all trying to do the wild thing? Or was it good? You know, like, you know who owns this house, right? Not that girl you're swimming right there. I don't know. Maybe you want to swim with the big sharks. That's all I'm trying to say. Like, I don't know. I'm not putting it past some moms out there to try to, like, swim their way into some wild thing action. I'm just saying. Scandalous moms be out there.
She's all, I got a better credit score, and I definitely got more insurance. Yeah,
start fucking stating the facts, trying to, like, you know, one-up the little...
Oh, I got daughter. A property in Wisconsin.
You ever been to Branson?
You the wild thing. Wild thing. Please, baby, baby, please. Posse in effect. Hanging out is always hype. And with me and the crew leave a shindig, I'm with a girl who's just my type. Saw this luscious little frame, I ain't lying, fella, she was fine. This sweet young Miss Cole gave me a kiss and I knew that she was mine. Took her to the limousine, and still parked outside. I tipped the chauffeur when it was over and I gave her my own ride. Didn't get her off my jock, she was, I like static cling. But that's what happens when body starts slapping from doing the wild thing. She wanted to do the wild thing.
He just continues to come up with different scenarios as to find his way to doing the wild thing with many different women is from what I'm getting the point
here. I mean, I think that's kind of the whole purpose of the song. I'm having a hard time following Tone Loc. I love his voice, but like some
no
of these
problem.
Stories,
I'll
I'm
get
just
that.
Like, yeah, yeah.
That's what I'm here to dissect for you. So he's hanging out with his posse, hanging out is always hype. And when me and the crew leave the shindig, I want a girl who's just his type. So when he's leaving, he wants to, you know, leave him with his posse. Time to leave. He got his girl. He wants to leave with a girl that's his type. Saw this luscious little frame, and he ain't lying to his boy. She was cute. The sweet young thing gave me a kiss, and I knew that she was his. So somehow, some way, Tone Loc has the ability to just look at girls, like them, and they somehow reciprocate, give him kisses. And this girl was even down to go to the limousine that was parked right outside, of which Tone Loc had to tip the chauffeur, which I don't know why he would have to because he's paying the chauffeur anyway.
I don't know. I mean, like, is it even been made clear that this is his limo? It
yeah, he says, like took her to the limousine, still parked outside. I mean, it doesn't say his, but I guess he could have gotten some random person's limousine. That'd be kind of funny. Like, is that a limousine? Hey, yo, chauffeur, is the owner inside? Let me tip you and get in there. Use it for about 10 minutes. What do you say? $100? He tipped the chauffeur after it was over for some reason because he wanted to give her his own ride, which I guess he drove her in his own car. Don't know what's happening there.
Yeah, so he drove his own car. Yeah, there's a limo involved. Like, I don't think that's his limo. That's
he
all
got
I'm
some random limo?
Yeah, I think he said that she just started walking towards the limo and he just was like, looked around and he rolled with it. So he tipped the chauffeur like, hey.
Oh,
hey.
Wow. And then he says she couldn't get it off my jack. She was like a static cling, but that's what happens when a body starts slapping and they start doing the wild thing. So this girl, every time he gets with a girl that he just sees, doesn't say a word, they end up hooking up within a couple minutes, it seems like. And then each girl is like stuck on him. One, the mom got involved. This girl wants to keep him. And then I forget what the first girl was, but Tone Loc must have balls of steel.
I'm going to say this. Do you remember a couple episodes back when we were dissecting Soul Decision? And you kept hating on the guy for being like, man, you need to just make moves. Like, you're acting like, oh, you don't know exactly what you want
to
do.
I remember that yes. Vividly, episode 27.
And I was saying, this song is actually speaking of, more realistically, how shit goes when you're out there. Because a lot of these songs are this shit right here, where it's just like, all the dude has to do is just give a girl a wink out of his car, and she's like, oh, I'm going to jump in and do the wild thing. Gives that girl a head nod of the mall, and she's like, let's do the wild thing. You know, everything is just like he does have to do nothing. And then suddenly even the mom wants to do the wild thing.
Wait, you're telling me that that's how normal life works? Is this is what Tone Loc is doing is what typically happens?
No, it's literally the opposite of
that. Oh, okay. That's why I thought I heard what you said and I was getting
you clearly there. Didn't. As what I was saying, the entire episode of Soul Decision, that was the more realistic thing. Whereas there's so many of these artists that play it off like there's some dope-ass, untouchable Lothario that just, like, give a girl a head nod and they just lose it and they jump all over them. Like, that's not really how it goes. Even probably for a lot of these musicians. I don't believe that Tone Loc was crushing it this bad. He was probably killing it in, like, 93 or whenever this was.
Yeah.
But... yeah, like, not to this level. You know, they always gotta, like, overestimate how good they really are out there in the streets. And, like, Soul Decision, they were being real. They were being like, you know, the end of the night, am I feeling this right? Am I making my move tonight? Go back and listen to episode 27.
All right.
Look at our catalog.
We got a lot of good ones. One more situation that Tone Loc wants to get into.
You got another one? Dude, how are we going to get through two songs?
We will get through it. Here we go. Extra smooth breakdown.
Does this the same thing, though? Is this going to be the same kind of, like, basically he just does nothing and they just jump all over him?
We'll see. I don't know. I want to see what he does. I never actually played this song out long enough to hear this last
verse. Nobody
has. I know. All right, let's see what he says. Here he goes. Here he goes.
Doing a little show at the local discotheque. This fine young chick was on my jock, so I said, what the heck? She wanted to come on stage and do a little dance. So I said, chill for now, and maybe later you'll get your chance. So when the show was finished, I took her around the way. And what do you know? She was good to go without a word to say. We was all alone and she said, Tone, let me tell you one thing. I need $50 to make you holler. I get paid to do the wild thing. Say what?
Oh. Yo, love you. Finally.
Yo, walk ready? Just break out of here. I'm still a big stop, baby.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Did we not call that from the very jump? Right, this so man might be messing with ladies that like to get paid to do the wild thing.
Yeah, he went until verse 4 to actually drop that, like, yeah, by the way, I'd be paying all these girls out. Like, yeah. I don't tell you about the checkbook transaction, but yeah, no, that's...
I mean, I bet, yeah.
He's
I mean,
just going...
Literally no way you can meet girls as quick as this man is meeting them and get to what he's getting to, known as the wild thing, and not be doing a little bit extra... Possibly payment. I mean, I guess there is chances, but not as consistent as Tone Loc is being.
Not really,
especially
though.
In this song.
You're like Leonardo DiCaprio or something, maybe, but like, these were all such like minimal. This fool's just been riding around like the red light district this whole time, just scooping them into the ride, jumping into a limo that's not even his. They were pumping, working it. Suddenly the mom was like, oh, I know what my daughter does, but I'll let you get on this for free. That actually makes more sense now, you know? All of it. I'm glad that he didn't withhold that information from us the entire song.
Oh, exactly. So, let us know the variant. So with that said, Castle, I really wanted to get into this next song because as he's talking about what he's paying for the wild thing in the first one, I want you to listen to the second one because I found this out recently by listening to this on a road trip that this song actually is much deeper than we all want to think about. So we're getting into it. Funky Cold Medina, time to dissect it. Let's go.
Hit it. Hi, nigga. Come on.
We back.
Dissect DJs again. Part two. Cool and at a bar. I'm looking for some action, but like Mick Jagger said, I can't get no satisfaction. The girls are all around, but none of them wanna get with me. My threads are fresh and I'm looking deaf. Yo, what's up with LOC? The girls are all jocking at the other end of the bar, having drinks with some no-name chump when they know that I'm a star. So I gotta be strolled over to the other side of the cantina. I asked the guy why he's so fly. He said, Funky Cold Medina.
Right away, I'm just gonna say this, even though I'm very familiar with both these songs. Damn, they sound like the same song. Like, if I was zoned out and I wasn't really paying attention, I would have thought the same song was playing right now. It's got that same kind of, like, 90s keyboard that, like, I got for Christmas when I was 8. And, like, like, I remember, like, making beats like that with a little keyboard I had, a little, like, scratch pad and everything. And it's the same exact rhythm that he's telling the story with. Like,
I agree.
It's probably the reason why Tone Loc didn't have another album out of this. He's acting.
And probably why you didn't want to do a whole week of this. But I get it, Castle. Yeah.
He's
very simply at the bar, and no girls are trying to get with him.
Oh, okay.
So another guy is at the end of the bar. All the girls are jocking him.
Okay.
He wants to figure out why. He walks up to the guy. He says, "Why you so fly?" The guy says, Funky Cold Medina. What do you get from that so far? Quick description.
Motherfucker was high as shit, and he was just like not trying to spit game out to the dude that's hit him up. He's like, yeah, Funky Cold Medina. Stop talking to me, bro. That's
Leave me alone. I got all the girls next to me and shit. All right. But why are the girls next to him is what I'm asking. Why would you think all the girls are...
Based on his last story, I'm going to guess that he's still hanging around hookers, and then that was the pimp.
keeping it rolling.
secret on how to get more chicks. Put a little Medina in your glass and the girls will come real quick. It's better than any alcohol or aphrodisiac. A couple of sips of this love potion and she'll be on your lap. So I gave some to my dog when he began to beg. And then he licked his bowl and he looked at me and did a wild thing on my leg. He used to scratch and bite me before he was much, much meaner. But now all the poodles run to my house for the funky Cold Medina. You know what I'm saying?
I'm afraid I do.
My door. I got spuds, baby.
What do you,
If I just heard that right, home dude that he asked for some game tips from said he's got some potion, hooked him up with some of the potion. For some reason, Tone decides to trial this shit on his dog. His dog goes to work on his leg immediately, and then next thing you know, the rest of the week, all the dogs in the neighborhood are
specifically
running.
Specifically the poodles.
That's like the worst kind of dog you could have, like, so going to train on your leg.
Have you figured out what this Medina, funky Cold Medina, is that
is that the of? Like the potion that he was using?
Yeah, what are you taking the potion as?
I mean some kind of magic bullshit.
See, the moment I got to this point, I'm gonna go ahead and say what I thought, and then we got one more line after this. This man is giving date rape drugs. Funky Cold Medina is very simply a date rape drug, and this is how he's gonna get women. And he puts it in their alcohol and they get an aphrodisiac.
Okay, I thought like a date rape drug was like it just like knocks him out or
passed
something.
Passed out, yeah.
It?
I mean, there's.
I mean, that's not what happened to the dog. The dog started going to town on his leg.
He couldn't say that in a song, I guess. Like, yeah. I gave it to her. She passed out, and I dragged her ass to the hotel. Yeah, like, yeah. He wanted, that'd be fucking crazy.
It would have gotten dark quick.
But it's already dark. Like, this guy's giving.
It's a good reason that nobody can really understand what Tone is saying in
Tone
these songs.
Tone is sneaking in a potion, a substance of some sort, in these ladies' drinks. The ladies are getting happy and horny, apparently, and therefore that's how he's able to then get with these women. This is what this guy gave him. Funky Cold Medina is a date rape drug, and this shit is fucked up!
Yeah.
I got every dog in my neighborhood breaking down my door. I got Spuds, BNC, Alex, and Strohs. They want me, my dog, along with that Medina, pal. I went up to this girl. She said, hi, my name is Sheena. I thought she'd be good to go with a little funky Cold Medina. She said, I like a drink. I said, I'll go get it. And then a couple of sips, she go lick the lips, and I knew that she was with it. So I took her to my crib, and everything went well as planned. But when she got her dress, it was a big old mess. Sheena was a man. So I threw her mouth. I don't fool around with no Oscar Mayer wiener. You must be sure that your girl is pure for the funky Cold Medina. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no plans with a man. This is the 80s and locals down with the ladies.
Even more evidence to show that this man is giving a substance to women that is changing them from not liking them or being okay to now wanting to do them. And it's not only works with ladies, but it works for men as well. So
what?
He gave the substance to what he thought was a lady. He took her home,
shit.
And it was a man.
Hey, he's hanging out in all different parts of town.
What is? Where, Tone Loc, where are you going to party?
Wait, I don't know where he's
both episodes, your ass is going. You're giving random substances to girls. You're hanging out with ladies that get paid for your party life. Though it makes it sound somewhat fun and enjoyable, really is a little bit.
He's in some sketchy parts of town.
You're in some sketchy.
But he's
parts
engaging. This dude tells him about it like a date rape drug he's got, and his first thing is to be like, "Yo, let me get some of that. I'm gonna try it on my dog. Then I'm gonna try it out on Sheena." You know?
Okay, so he just got done dealing with a man. Last verse. I bet there's gonna be a breakdown right here. Just wildly from the wild thing. Here it comes.
Break it down.
You called it earlier, man. He literally does the exact same thing with just a slightly different beat.
Yeah.
Has a breakdown at the exact same moment.
He just kind of changed the tempo on it a little bit, I think.
No tempo change, just a slight.
Actually, the tempo is exactly the same. Yeah, it's like a pitch change. I wouldn't really call that a breakdown.
That was like
he took away, he just took away one of the instruments.
The guitar left.
On the keyboard, he just like undid one of the buttons.
The guitar
real
was
quick.
Left.
Yeah.
All right, last verse.
Looking for a little affection. I took a shot as a contestant on the love connection. The audience voted, and you know they picked a winner. I took my date to the Hilton for Medina and some dinner. We had a few drinks. I'm thinking soon what I'll be getting. Instead, she started talking about plans for our wedding. I grabbed my coat and hit the door. I said, baby, I'll be seeing ya. That's why I found you don't fool around with the funky Cold Medina. You know what I'm saying? That Medina's a monster.
Alright, and in the final scene, Tone Loc out of nowhere decides to get on the Love Connection, and of course the people vote him as the winner. He decides to take the girl out for some Medina and some dinner. She tries to talk about getting married and for a wedding. He says, whoa, slow down. I found out I don't play around with that funky Cold Medina. So this date rape jug that he ends up giving all the ladies turned on him many different times, one of which it was a man. Second which, the lady wanted to go next level with him.
Wait, the other one was a dog, and he knew that was a dog.
Third one was a dog that he...
Yeah, well, he kind of willingly did that one. I don't think that could have...
Tone Loc, you're a dirtbag.
Man, I kind of liked Tone before we did Tone Loc Day.
Yeah, like, and now I look at Ace Ventura in a whole different perspective.
Which, by the way, one of my favorite quotes actually from Ace Ventura that I doubt that anybody else ever quotes is literally the first line when you get to the credits. And it's Ace simply saying... Hey, Tone, put on those big-ass size 13s and kick it for the homies.
Tone, put that big-ass size 13 on and kick it for the homies.
And then Tone Loc's, like, song for the credits comes on. I've always quoted that with my buddy Jay Miller. Shout out, Miller. Like, Tone's always been a cool-ass brother in my book. So, like, this is when we call when dissecting goes wrong.
We now hate, not hate, but we...
But you know what? You started the episode by saying I was hating on Tone. And I
don't hate
like,
him now. Fuck Tone Loc. What the fuck, you dirtbag?
Fucking...
Fuck getting, Tone Loc.
Running around, getting hookers all day. Then he goes get some fucking funky Cold Medina, like, using it on his dog. What?
Grossies.
No funky Cold Medina for you, all right?
Yeah, no poodles are coming for you, dude. No, no running around the neighborhood.
This ain't Tone Loc.
Yeah. Tone Loc would have gave you funky Cold Medina.
Oh, man. Not think about what Tone Loc about to do with your dog, man.
Yeah. All right, so we've knocked out two.
We've got to slap this out.
Slap this out. All right, let's just
slap it. You want to
do both separate or just do both together? Because they're both kind of the same song.
Fucking
same
song, man. All right. Yeah, I'm ready to just do it all in one go. All right,
we're slapping both these together. One song. What do we have? I'm gonna go ahead and.
Three slaps and a like an email sound or whatever. Yeah,
exactly.
I don't know if that'll actually show up in
there. But yeah, man, good song. Keeps me, both of them get me like dancing like a 90s feel. And when you don't listen to it, it just kind of has that ultimate 90s. The samplings are great from previous songs. So I definitely appreciate the song. However, what used to be a four song for me has definitely dropped significantly. And actually, I'm going to rebuttal my, I'm going to go back.
You really like to do this rebuttal bullshit.
So,
that's... Why'd you do that? Do you always, like, you bring it back to, so we're going to have the same kind of thing again? Just keep it at three, you know?
No, then... I don't like three. Three's too much for what he was talking about. He's disrespectful to women. He's possibly giving them date rape drug. He gets two at max and a very disappointing breath out of... Because, come on, Tone Loc, okay. Man, what are you doing, dude?
Let's just say this song would not fly in 2020. I don't even think this song would fly in 2010. 2000, we were still kind of a fucked up place, yeah, so it might have flown a little bit then. But
Pre-internet world, when everybody wasn't able to be called out for their shit.
When apparently rapping about date rape drugs was like a cool thing to do.
Yeah.
Get you some radio.
Sublime play. Did it, episode...
Yeah, right, there's a few ways. Episode 10. Look at her catalog again, you know? Once we get deep in the catalog.
All right, well, what are you slapping this one?
It was me.
If I could define this right, two slaps.
Cheap-ass little keyboard beat.
Cheap, repetitive keyboard beat and an Ambrosius bark. For the dogs at home. Okay.
Yeah. For the bullshit Describe. That he's pulling. Yeah. You know what? I've never been that crazy about either of these songs. Maybe it's just because, like, they got a little play-outness to me. But they're also just a little boring. Like, they don't really make me want to dance, other than, like, a little basic head nod. That's about as much as they've ever made me want to dance. Just, like, a little, just kind of, okay. That's the probably the first time I've, like, sat through and willingly listened to either one of them, because I definitely get bored with both tracks, like, after, like, one verse. And, like, I've never actually followed the story. So when you take that fall, which is probably good, that probably actually helped it, in hindsight, but, when you take out the actual following of the story, you're just kind of hearing the same beat with him doing the... Yeah, like, it's just kind of like, yeah, I get the vibe. I know it's not going. There's no pickup. There's no drop. There's no, like, break it down.
Yeah, that was a breakdown.
It wasn't a breakdown. He took, like, one instrument away off the keyboard. I'm saying. I'm going to stick to Tone Loc and Blank Check. That's his peak mountain for me. You know, Ace Ventura, he was cool in that too. I like him more as an actor, I'm going to say it, than I do as a rapper. That's my stance.
And in dissecting both of these songs, we found out Tone Loc was dealing with
sketchy paying for
Wild Thing, and as well as using a some type of substance to then get ladies to enjoy the Wild Thing with him.
Medina. Yeah.
Yo, real talk, Castle. Fuck Tone Loc, you dirtbag, bro. Straight up.
Damn, I hate saying that because I always liked the dude.
Nah, he made sneaky songs that are disrespectful, yeah, and he can go fuck himself.
Yeah.
And with that, I think I'm pretty much done with you, Tone Loc. I'm glad I didn't give you a fucking week.
Yeah, he didn't deserve a whole week, man. We're gonna turn with Dissect, huh? Now all of a sudden we're off the Tone Loc bandwagon.
Fuck Tone Loc. Next!